I'm Amine CHAFAI, and I'm happy today to have the opportunity to talk with you with an important subject for every software engineer and for every student in computer science. Before I tell you what is this subject, I will ask you to have some imagination. And let's assume that you get your diploma and you work for several years in a company, and one day you want to launch your own business, your own IT company. So, as you know, a company in IT technology, in IT field, needs software resources and hardware resources. But the problem will be that in the beginning of your activity, you don't have enough data to know how much software you will need and how much hardware you will need. So, you can do one thing. If you have enough money, you can buy several and numerous licenses of software and many servers and large connections to the internet. But as you know, it costs money. So instead of investing this money in some developing activities, you will invest it in this. So it's not good for your development. So what you can do is the other option, which is to invest in a reduced amount of software and hardware. And then, it's true, you will save money. But imagine that your company is a successful one and you get more customers than you estimated before. So the performance of your company will be reduced. It's not good for customers. So it's not good for your you will save money, you will be happy for the time, but you will underestimate the number of customers, so it's not good too. So how can you deal with these two extremes between underestimation and overestimation? And it's what we'll talk today about. It is cloud computing. So let's get a look to the outline. First, I will explain. First, we did the introduction. It's what we just seen. I will explain what is cloud computing. I will explain that it's an architecture, and I will move to the advantages and drawbacks. Then we will see with Rashid some practical and real-life examples in cloud services. Then he will give you a demo of virtualization using a virtual machine, and then we'll conclude. Okay, let's begin. Let's begin. Why they call it cloud computing? They call it cloud computing because when you delegate this task to managing software and hardware to others, you don't and you aren't aware about how they manage this work. So both software and hardware are in others, are managed by others. So you can focus on your core business value. Let's get a look to the architecture of cloud computing. At the basis, we had infrastructure as a service. Infrastructure includes servers and storage and connection to the internet, bandwidth, etc. But you know, hardware without any operating system on it, without any database management, is not useful. So you can purchase also the platform as a service. Platform as a service means that you choose your operating system in those servers. You choose your own database management, etc. At the top of this pyramid, we'll have software as a service. Software as a service is developed applications and ready to use. So you only have to get an account on this software and use it. let's do a comparison between classical model and cloud model. You can see here, the blue, in the blue we have the classical traditional model. At the beginning of your activity, you will purchase a high quantity of hardware and software that you won't use immediately. So all this will be used, lost, all this. But in the cloud model, you purchase only a reduced amount. And with the growth of activity, you can in five minutes, you can double or more your power. In 5 minutes, you can demand more servers, more platform, or more licenses of software. And vice versa, if the activity is decreases, you can in 5 minutes to enable, disable all servers you don't need. So you will save money in this, because you pay only for what you use. Okay, let's move to advantages of cloud computing. Cloud computing will help IT companies to optimize their IT services. Why? You can see in this cartoon that we have the main process and here are some intermediate processes that aren't directly in the main activity of the company. So instead of being disturbed by this intermediate processes, you can put it into the cloud for some specialized companies and focus on your core business value. Another advantage is scalability. By scalability, I mean the ability of technology to be adaptable with large area and small area in the company. So if your needs are big, you can take advantage from cloud computing. And also, if you are just a startup. Another advantage is self-service business model. Self-service means that you are who decide how service you need and you will start in it. Take 5 minutes to get all of your wants. But you know, nothing is free from drawbacks. So there is some risks. Risks concerns mainly security. As you know, if you put your data in a foreign server, you can't control it. So if it's this server is, for example, in the United States, and in the United States, you know there is a law which called Patriot Act, all federal authority will have access to this data. So it can be the risk for confidentiality or privacy. Lack of interoperability. Interoperability means the ability of technology to communicate with other technologies. Because the market is young, there is lack of interoperability. Market immaturity. Providers of cloud services haven't enough experience to provide some strong offers, but this will be developed in the future. Rashid, could you please give them some practical examples in cloud services? Good luck.
Our toilet is in.